hello, darling. This is Louis, darling. It's so nice to have you back where you belong. You looking swell, darling. I can't tell, darling. You still growing, you still growing, you still going strong. I feel the room swaying.
The year is 1933. This is one of the worst years for the Great Depression, with 25% of the United States citizens unemployed. This is also the year that prohibition laws were repealed, and alcohol once again returns to the American society. Strong winds and drought-stripped topsoils kick up huge dust storms, creating the Great Dust Bowl, and Alcatraz becomes a federal penitentiary. On November 16, 1933, we find the birth of Dolly Ann Stelmach. She is the daughter of Helen and George Stelmach and a sibling of Nick and Joni. Dolly was born at her parents' house only 4 days prior to that year's Thanksgiving. She would often joke that she was the celebration centerpiece for the family that year and not the turkey. Dolly's grandson, Michael, shares one of his experiences.
Some of my most vivid memories of my grandmother Dolly was back when I was a little kid, and when our family lived in Massachusetts, each year we would visit her in Scranton for Thanksgiving. And leading up to that, I was always so excited, obviously, to see her. But she would always ask me, you know, things in which I wanted to eat, you know. She would make specific things, whether it be like meatball subs or sausage, and always have that ready for me as soon as I got there. And just really meant a lot to me, knowing that she cared that much, even though we didn't see each other that often, being in different states. And just being there for Thanksgiving, I was always so excited to just drive up to Pennsylvania, even if it was like a 6-hour drive, to see Grandma Dolly and, you know, just enjoy each other's company. This is something that, you know, I really remember most fondly of my grandmother, and although it seems kind of small in the sense that it was just her making some specific meal, it just meant so much to me when I would go up there and visit and have that experience with her, and that bond that, you know, I otherwise wouldn't have if I just remained in Massachusetts. So that's what I remember most.
In the year 1951, Dolly graduates from West Scranton High School. While in school, her favorite activities were the Glee Club, Pep Club, and her favorite class, sewing. From the year 1949 through 1951, as a teenager, Dolly worked at Woolworth's lunch counter. This iconic brand was known for its sandwiches, hot soups, coffee, and salads. From the year 1951 through 1965, Dolly also worked for Golo Footwear. This iconic and world-known brand was located in Dunmore, Pennsylvania. Golo initially designed and manufactured slippers in Dunmore, Pennsylvania. The company was known for experimenting with materials not traditionally used in footwear, such as cork, stretch fabrics, Gore-Tex for rain boots, and clear lucid sandal wedges. Golo boot and shoe designs graced the covers and pages of every fashion magazine from 1950 through the 1980s. The footwear was photographed by some of the most admired photographers in the fashion industry, including Helmut Newton, Bert Stern, Hero, and Richard Avedon. Known for the famed go-go boot worn by Barbra Streisand in the 1960s, the boot was heralded for its new and innovating design, in part by being bigger than the ordinary shoe, but smaller than the regular boot, as if a true boot had been lopped off from the top before it grew to full height. Dolly also spent a lot of time in New York City. In the summer, she would stay with her Aunt Jewel for vacation. At nighttime, she would go out with her girlfriends at famous places like the Peppermint Lounge and the Copacabana. In addition to the nightclubs, Dolly also enjoyed musicals and plays in New York City and had seen West Side Story, Hello Dolly, and The Music Man. In addition to vacationing in New York City, Dolly also liked to spend time in Fort Lauderdale, Florida. She would take spring break trips there with her girlfriend. In 1961, Dolly met Jack Labaranti. She was getting gas at one of his service stations, and he had asked her out. They were married on October 7th, 1961, in Scranton, Pennsylvania. In 1964, Dolly and Jack both went to see the World Fair in Flushing Meadows, New York. The theme for the fair was Peace Through Understanding, and it was dedicated to man's achievement on a shrinking globe in an expanding universe. The fitting centerpiece was a 140-foot-high, 700,000-pound stainless steel Unisphere, the most recognizable symbol of the fair. The Unisphere has become an icon of Queens. Hundreds of unique pavilions radiated from the Unisphere, representing foreign lands, technology, transportation, and government. From 1962 through 1976, Dolly and Jack would take vacations down to Atlantic City. They would take Valerie Labaranti, their daughter, and they would all enjoy the sights and sounds and smells of the beach, enjoying the steel pier, peanuts, popcorn, cotton candy, and all of the entertainment. Dolly's daughter, Valerie, shares one of her stories.
What I remember and will always remember about Dolly are the many long summer days spent with her and my friends in our backyard. Dolly was with us every day, swimming, playing with the dogs in the pool, and the ceramics, crafts, and dolls, and more dolls. We had a big picnic table to paint our ceramic treasures. Dolly taught us how to paint and create our masterpieces. She told us how amazing our finished pieces were. There was nothing better than hearing that to young girls. We also, at least once a week, went to the fabric center. Dolly would create an outfit for me, her, and Barbie. She said, go pick out your pattern and material. Just make sure the pattern does not have zippers. Zippers were not her thing. They were truly the glory days of summer with my Dolly and girlfriends. I will never forget it. True mother, friend, and role model.
During this time, Dolly would also go with Jack as he participated in handball tournaments throughout the United States and Canada. The two also enjoyed going to Philadelphia, where they would catch a Phillies game or a Sixers basketball game. From 1967 through 1976, Dolly also assisted her husband Jack by managing his gas station and parking lot, located in Scranton and Dunmore. In addition to helping her husband Jack manage his service station and parking lot, Dolly also worked at Consolidated Molded Products, at one time the largest plastic facility in the world, located in Scranton, Pennsylvania. In 1978, Dolly partnered with Jack to run a deli business in the Pine Brook area of Scranton, Pennsylvania. This business became known as Jack and Dolly's Deli. They ran that business from 1978 through 1985 when Jack retired. In addition to managing the deli with Jack, Dolly also worked at the Leukemia Society from around 1975 through 1980. After Jack's retirement in 1985, Dolly wanted to continue working. So she took a job at Laurel Hill Nursing Home, located in Dunmore, Pennsylvania, where she managed the kitchen. Unfortunately, that facility burned down in 2016. In 1995, Dolly retired from the Laurel Hill Nursing Home. From that point forward, she began to create dolls. She had an extraordinary talent and could take raw fabrics and materials and create these beautiful, stunning dolls. She would take these dolls and end up giving them to children, those less fortunate, and some of the elderly that were in the nursing home. While she was making these dolls and giving them away, she also took care of her husband, Jack, who became ill. Jack passed away on July 7th, 2012. And after over 50 years of marriage, Dolly found herself alone. During their time together, Dolly and Jack always had pets. The family, including Valerie, absolutely adored animals, and there was always a couple of dogs in the home. Shortly after Jack's passing in 2012, their last pet, Mighty Mite, had passed away. It was by that year end that Dolly discovered a program from the Humane Society that connects older dogs with the elderly. It was at this time that she adopted a black chihuahua, which she affectionately named Molly. Dolly always loved to keep busy and remained very active. In addition to taking care of Molly, Dolly would spend a lot of time with her sister, Joni. The two would go out to lunch and shop together almost every day. Dolly loved to shop for vintage clothing. She had a keen eye and a savvy ability to find deals that no one else could find. She would take these items that she would purchase and give them to her daughter, Valerie. Dolly also loved to cook and was very creative with food. She would watch cooking shows throughout the day and interpret their recipes into her own way of cooking. She was never afraid to experiment with new items or new ideas. She would love to cook throughout the week and then take the food items that she made and freeze them, so that when her daughter Valerie came to visit, she would have a bountiful gift to take back home with her. Dolly loved many things in life. Some of her favorite movies included Dr. Zhivago, Godfather, and Dolores Claiborne. She was fond of Elvis Presley, Nat King Cole, Tina Turner, and Tony Bennett. Her TV show favorites include Friends, Carol Burnett Show, and Golden Girls. She was fond of an actor, Sean Connery, Robin Williams, and the actress Kathy Bates and Ellen DeGeneres. And her favorite things to do throughout the day or evening was to be around kids, play with her dogs, be creative with her dolls, work with her ceramics, work with sewing and designing, work on creative cooking. She loved vintage shopping, and when she came up to New England to visit her daughter in the summertime, she would love to go to the Christmas tree shop. When Dolly would visit Valerie in New England, she would love to spend time with Michael, her grandson. Michael would have many of his friends come over, and they would have sleepovers during the summertime because they would want to be with Dolly. You would often find them going out and swimming at 10 and 11 o'clock at night and enjoying the company of each other. Dolly loved all of her family. Dolly was an incredible person with an extraordinary personality. She was larger than life. She loved to do things her way. She was fiercely independent, but at the same time, loving and caring to all those around her. Dolly loved her family and cared deeply for those around her. She had a unique way of looking at the world, and she will be greatly missed by all of those who know her and love her.
I feel the room sway while the band's playing one of our old favorite songs from way back when. So take a rap, fellas, find an empty lap, fellas. Dolly, never go.